Katong por mi roja pa... Naano po na yung... Di man ito makabinuang direk istorya, no? Naman na juril direk CCTV na to. Mag-erase ako ng mga point plus. Ito ako, madam. Wala, COVID na. Ha? Ago. Okay, sige, padayon ta class. No ay no nga nagampo ng tanan ganiha pala pagsugod class, kay basig mo sobraan ta o gampo padayon na dayon ta. Okay, sige, good afternoon. And this afternoon class, we will be talking about, no, this is the continuation from the previous discussion that we had last meeting. So which is about parabola, no? Last meeting, gi-discuss na to ang parts of parabola, no? There are different parts of parabola, properties of parabola, na naana siya para makuha nato ang standard equation. So, basi mag-wonder mo nga, sir, daghan pa man ay parts sa parabola nga napatay katong napatay sa tawag na to aning katong asymptotic axis, napatay mga no, daghay pa part especially pag atong i-graph. So, ang atong buhaton lang this times are those properties in parabola and sa definition, no? And also equation of hyperbola rather. So, mora na atong now ang continuation ana especially kato moabot na mo sa pinaka deeper na nga ano ana no is dito na nasa niya pag sa college nga part. So, balik mabalik magapon ng mga questions. Okay, so last meeting of course. Sige. Last meeting, no, na ato agi-discuss na to ang parts of parabola. Natay gitawag nga transversal, naatay conjugate, naatay focal distance, naakay gitawag nga say tawag na to ani represent as A, B, C, and ang sapato dito ang mga notation. Okay? So pag mo yung kag principal axis na diha makita tanan, no, diha nato makita tanan ang atong center, ang vertex, ang focus, no. Kung kana nga linya na diha na contain na ang mga points or properties of hyperbola and kana nga axis is what we call the principal axis. Okay, a measure nato, no, from center to up, that is the measurement or the length of line segment is our B and center to down is also B. So therefore, ang atong conjugate axis is equal to 2B. No, mo na atong gi-mention last meeting. And also from center to the right, no, from the first vertex that is A, center to the second vertex is also A. So therefore, ang atong transverse axis is equal to 2A. Now, gikan center to the focal, the first focus is C, then center to second focus is also C. Now the distance from focus 1 to focus 2, that is 2C ang iyang length. So mo na ang part sa atong hyperbola. Now let us proceed to examples. Okay, thank you sir. So let example number 1, if the focal distance of a hyperbola is 10 units and half of its transverse axis is 8 units. What is the distance from the center of the hyperbola to one of the endpoints of the conjugate axis? So ang atong ipangutana diha or ang iyang ipangita is distance from the center, no? Gikan sa center daw of the hyperbola to one of the endpoints of the conjugate. Pag may ka-conjugate, di ba? No? Pag na daw kay inani daw ko, no? Ang tawag daw nato aning this is a Cartesian plane. Sa Cartesian plane, naada ko no kay hyperbola, na kay focal distance. Pag muhisgot ang focal distance, that is the measurement from center to, unsa man, focus, focal distance. And ang value niya, ana, is, or ang notation na gamito na to, ana, class, is, mo na ang atong C. Okay. This one, niya kong mag-ingon tag-focus na adaw diria o diria. Now, gikan daw diria from center to this one, ang measurement daw niya ana, that is 10 units. Second, half of its transverse, pag may kag-transverse or transverse axis kay 8 units, half man. So therefore, gikan daw diria, padulong diria, mo man atong half of transverse, which is equal to 8. Okay, kabalot ta that from center to half of the transverse, that is A. Then from center to our focus one, mo na atong C, which is equal to 10. Now, question niya, what is the distance from center to center of the hyperbola to one of its endpoints of conjugate? Ang diria. Pila daw, di ba? Ang kaninga distance pa dong sa center, this is denoted as B. So therefore, naadaw kuno kay value sa A, na kay value ni C, pero kay value ni B. Okay. Diha, pag maghisgotag C, that is the focal distance or ang focus. So focus, that's 10. Ang atong A is equal to 8 units. Now, what is B? Okay, inana atong problem. Now, to solve, we need to use the Pythagorean theorem. Okay. Sa Pythagorean theorem, sa ellipse class, no, pag maghisgot ang ellipse, atong gigamit is a squared is equal to b squared plus c squared. Now, this time, in relation to this one, naghisgot akang hyperbola. Pag hyperbola daw kuno ang atong isolve, mahimo na siya, atos ang i-rewrite, no, mag-derive tag formula from the Pythagorean theorem, and this will become b squared is equal to c squared minus a squared. And this is now our formula in finding in or solving one of the properties of hyperbola given its transverse, conjugate, and its focal distance. Now, since a and c is given, all we need to do is apply substitution. Okay, using b squared is equal to c squared is equal b squared is equal to c squared minus a squared. B is wala, so just copy b squared. It's equal to c is 10. Namura pa makughubog class. No. Ko ano kaning katugon ni kay ko do. Gitan pa ko nang api. Okay, pagpasensyahan. Okay, ang atong a is 8. No? 8 squared. No, ko basig na ko mali nga ma-mention ba. So i-correct lang ko class. Okay, wa may musagpa dire nga. No, lagyo man kay sila. Tugon pa kayo ko. Okay, b squared, copy lang tana class do. So asa si 10, that's the value of c. 8 is the value of a, which is aniya siya. Then simplify b squared, copy lang ta. Then simplify 10 squared and 8 squared. 10 squared, that's 10 times 10 or equal to 100. Minus 8 squared or 8 times 8, that is 64. Now to find the value of b, simplify lang ka. B squared is equal to 100 minus 64. What is 100 minus 64 class? That is
36.
Okay, that is 36. Okay. So 36 ang atong given karon. Now, find the value of B. Okay, find the value of B. What is the value of B now?
6.
Okay, that is equal to 6. Okay, so therefore 6 ang atong given. Sir, di ba kay pag maghisgotag roots kay no square root of b is square root of b squared is b, square root of 36, that's positive negative 6. Now, before ta mo arrive ana, mo take sa tag absolute value of positive negative 6, that is equal to no positive negative man ang roots of 36. So that is positive 6. Ngano man sir, tungod kay no we are talking about, di ba? We are talking about distance. Again, distance. So in physics, dili pag mag-abot mo sa physics, wala magitay distance na mag-negative, di ba? Wala tay distance na mag-negative. So therefore, ang atong B is just 6 units. No? That is 6 units. That is on how to find value of B. So therefore, ang ato daw B is 6, then naandaraw yun tay in aning nga graph. So, gikan daw diri sa center to A is, this is A. gikan kang center to focus is 10. Ang center to vertex ay one of its conjugate is 6. So gikan dire padungan hi, gikan na pud ngan hito dire is 10. Ya gikan dire padungan ha, that is 6. In ana ang pag ano no atong gi plot siya. Question on how to find the conjugate and points of conjugate given value of A and C using Pythagorean theorem. Pangutana dire nga area class. Question? Wala?
Wala, sir.
Okay. Sa class. So find the distance from the center of hyperbola to one of its vertices. Okay, find the distance from the center of hyperbola to one of its vertices. Pangitaon daw nato. Unsay atong ipangita diha class? A, B, or C? Now, find the distance from the center of a hyperbola to one of its vertices if the focal distance is 13 and the distance from the center to endpoint of conjugate axis is 12 units. Now, based from the given number 2 or problem number 2, unsay itong ipangita? A?
A, sir.
B?
A.
Or C? Okay. Nga nung A, man?
A.
Tungod ka? Unsay gimension niya diha? Nga mahimo na tong clue nga A atong ipangita. That is? Okay. Find the distance in niya. Find the distance from the center of hyperbola to one of its vertices. Pag mention na one of its vertices, meaning to say, it refers to the value of. Okay. So, niingon man siya na ana daw. Then, ang B daw, ang C, ang B and C is given. Ang focal distance, mao man na atong C. So, okay. So, karon na kay B and C. Pangitaon nato si A. So, using B squared is equal to C squared minus A squared. So, B is 12 squared is equal to C is 13 squared minus A squared. Okay. Simplify 12 square pila class. That is 100. Okay, that's 144. It's equal to, how about say 13 squared? What, 100?
69.
Okay, that's 169 minus A squared. Then to simplify, si A squared using addition and subtraction property, ibalhin na to sa picas, this will become positive A squared is equal to 169. Nya kani si 144, ibalhin na to through subtraction property. So mahimo siya ang 144. Negative. Then simplify, we have A squared is equal to 169 minus 144. Pila class? That 25. Is 25. Now, find the value of A. That's square root of A squared is A. Then square root of 25, that's positive negative 5. Absolute value of positive negative 5, that's positive 5. Therefore, A is just equal to 5 units in a given hyperbola. Question?
Answer.
Okay.
Answer.
Thank you.
Sir, ako yung nakoy pangutana, sir.
Ella?
If, baliho na to, sir. Kunwari, sir, A squared equals B squared minus C squared. Maunang formula, sir. Maurag yapon ang result niya, sir.
Yes, maurag yapon. Again, ang mag-base na always sa ato, kung pag atong hisgutan is hyperbola, dirirata kanirang notation atong gamiton. Okay?
Okay, sir. Thank
mag-base
you.
Mag-base na ato, ellipse sa tong gamiton, direct na mag-base. Pero actually, maumaura man na siya. A squared is equal to B squared plus C squared. Muna ang atong, ano. Pero, ellipse man, hyperbola, ka direct na mag-base. B squared is equal to C squared minus A squared. So, kana siya, no? Direct na mag-base always. If we are tasked to find other side of hyperbola, no? Ng A, B, and C. Okay? So, in anisya, so if B is 12, 13 is our C, then A is just equal to 5 using this Pythagorean theorem. Okay, next, how about class if ang atong given kay ano na, naanatay foci or value of our focus, no, duha man natong focus, given ang focus 1 o focus 2, find the distance from the center of hyperbola to one of its vertices if the endpoints of conjugates access are 0 and positive negative 6. No, ang gighatag diha nga part plus kay ang foci o ang conjugate. Pila kaha ang atong, no? Pila daw kaha ang atong distance from the center of the hyperbola to one of its vertices. Pag may kag one of its vertices, unsay gipangita? A, B, C, or A, B, or C? Plus. No? Find. Ingon niya. Find the distance from the center of hyperbola to one of its vertices. Kaning word nga to one of its vertices, unsa na siya? Unsa gipangita? That is? Pila to?
A.
Ang gipangita is A. Okay? So, sunod, ang given diha, foci, that refers to our C. Then, ang one of its conjugate, axis, na adaw ko no, given, that is our B. So, still, ang atong ipangita, pila ka si A. Now, una na tong buhaton class, we need to determine the known values. What are the known values? Since, nahisgutan man nato si C ug B, pila kay values ni C ug B? So, we can deduce the value of C since the distance between two foci is 16. So, tanawa, ingon niya diha a class, no? Ato daw ko nung ato i kuan locate sa atong ingon niya diha gikan daw ko no sa center, no? Ingon niya ang ato daw ang focus or foci is positive negative 8, then ang y nga value is 0, so therefore nasa origin padung daw diri sa right iyang focus kay na daw positive 8, padung sa right na daw siya negative 8. Now ang distance gikan center to the right to the left is positive negative 8. Now, remember, pag moing kag distance, refers only to positive value. Kay y negative nga distance. Therefore, ang atong C di class kay 8. Second, naasa iyang given. If the endpoints of the conjugates are axes are at 0, 0 daw si x, diri a. Then positive 6, then negative 6. Now, remember, distance gikan the center to this one is 6. Distance gikan center to this one is also 6. Now, pag may hisgot tag distance, always positive ang value niya. So that is positive 6 units. Okay. Now, ang atong buhaton anak class, no, we need to use again the formula since we are trying to find the value of our A. Okay. All you have to do is just copy the formula then apply substitution. Okay. So, that's 8. Then, given B squared is equal to C squared minus A squared. Okay. So, given man taog B, which is 6, then to the power of 2, which is equal to C, is 8 squared minus A squared. Okay. So, 6 squared, that is 36, which is equal to 8 squared is 64. Minus A squared. Now, to solve or to simplify, apply lang taog addition and subtraction property. So, kaniya from negative A squared, may mo siyang positive A squared is equal to 64 minus, no, from positive 36, may mong negative 36 according to subtraction and addition property of equality. So, naanatayin anang format, A squared is equal to 64 minus 36, pila man class. That is?
28.
Okay, that is 28. Okay. So, square root of 28, pila man. Square root of A is A. Square root of 28, pila. Na ba? Okay. Wala. Okay, next. Atong buhaton, pag wala gani class, no? According to rules of integer, no, kung napamoy libro de sa di na ako mag-discuss sa rules of radicals, kabalo ko nga niagi na mo ana. So all you have to do is mag-review mo ana ang area. So according to the rules of radicals, no, pag inani daw form class square root of 28, no, to simplify this one, mangita ka og factor ni 28 nga ang isa ka number is perfect square o ang isa is a prime number. Now, unsa nga number pag atong i-multiply mahimong 28? Na kay 4 times
7.
Okay. Now, 4 is a perfect square. 7 is a prime number. Now, si 4 og 7 are factors of 28. 4 times 7 is 28. Now, remember, 4 is a perfect square. So, therefore, square root of 4, that is 2. Then, 7 is a prime number. Square root of 7 is just square root of 7. Therefore, the value of our A is just equal to 2 square root of 7. And that is now our answer. Therefore, the distance from the center to either vertex is 2 square root of 7. Meaning, gikan daw diri apadong sa kung kani atong graph, gikan diri apadongan he is 2 square root of 7 iyang kalayon. So, inana ang iyang buot pasabot. Kuha? Nakuha?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Kindly SS, no, this will serve as your that work. Okay. The foci of hyperbola are at positive 12, negative 12. Now, positive, negative 12, 0. Find the distance from the center of hyperbola to one of its vertices if the endpoints of the conjugate axis are at 0, positive, negative 10. So, given kag conjugate, given kag foci, pangitao na to ang distance from the center of the hyperbola to one of its vertices. So, same in ani una to, then that will serve as your set work. Okay? Sige, thank you. Next, how about if in ani atong given? Now, the foci of hyperbola are at positive negative 4, 0. So, find the distance from the center of the hyperbola to one of the vertices if P is negative 5, 3 is a point on the graph. Okay. So, ang atong given karon class, dili na diretso ang iyang vertex, dili na diretso ang iyang unsay tawag na to, ani, conjugate. No? Wala na niya gihatag. Kundi, ang iyang gihatag diha class kay ang foci or ang points sa atong focus, then ang atong vertex. Point sa atong hyperbola, which is 5, negative 5 and positive 3. Okay. Una na itong buhaton diha ang apart class, no? Okay. Una na itong buhaton diha, of course, we need to recall that the difference between the distances from any point to the foci of hyperbola is equal to the length of the transverse axis, which is equal to 2a. Now, to solve the given problem, we first get the difference between distances from point P to foci. Then equate that one to 2A. Kadumdum pa mo atong sa atong ellipse, no? Kuhaan ang D1 ug ang D2, no? Distance 1 ug ang distance 2 at itong gi-add. Now, ang process diri ang area class, same dito a. Kuhaon nato ang D1, ang D2, then atong i-subtract diri a. Dito sa ellipse is add, diri a is subtract. So we have no step 1 ato sang isulat ang given. Ay, given diri a kay naa kay focus. Now si focus 1 given niya the first focus that's positive negative 1. So first focus is positive 4 0. F2 nato or second focus that's negative 4 0. Then ang ato dai yung ikaduha is ang P or ang point negative 5 o positive 3. Okay, mo nang tulo na to. Kanyang F1, F2, F1 is the first focus, F2 is the second focus then atong point. Okay, so step number 1, find the distance from the point, no, from the given point to the foci. Okay, pangitaon na to ang distance. Of course, pag pangitaon na to ang D1, no, or the first distance is equal to, unsa gani ang formula in finding distance? The distance using distance formula. Anyone?
X sub 1 minus
X sub 1 minus X sub 2
plus
squared plus
Y sub 1 minus Y sub 2
plus Y sub 2 I minus Y sub 2 squared. Okay. So muna ang atong formula. Now, una na itong buhaton, of course, para makuha na ito ang first distance, unahon po nato itong pinaka-formiro. Okay. So, D1, diri ka kang F1. F1 given by 4, 0 ug ang atong p given by negative 5 and positive 3. Okay, mo na tong unahon og kuha. Now d1, remember d1 is equal d sub 1 is equal to the square root of okay, square root of x this is di na natubutan ang x. Okay, si x karon class mo na pinakauna nga element again, pinakauna nga element naa sa atong ordered pair. Okay. Si y mo nang ikaduha nga element nga naa sa atong ordered pair. Now based from f1 and p1, una nga element dere is 4, una dere is negative 5. Ikaduha is 0, ikaduha is 3. So mo na atong identify. So x sub 1 mo na si 4 minus x sub 2 mo na si negative 5 square plus y sub 1 is 0 minus y sub 2 is 3 square. Then simplify. So we have d sub 1 is equal to the square root of we have 4, then negative times negative 5, that's positive 5 square plus 0 minus 3, that's negative 3 square. Then simplify. Ato na dayon na siyang i-finalize. D sub 1 is equal to the square root of okay, 4 plus 5, that's 9 squared plus negative 3 square. So ato na simplify, that is equal to positive 9. Okay, 9 square, so D sub 1 is equal to 9 square is 81 plus 9. So 81 plus 9, that is pila class, that is square root of 90. Okay. What is square root of 90 class? Kung ato na siyang isimplify through radical rules.
9 times that 10. Is
9. So na kay 9, square root of 9 times 10. 9 is a perfect square. 10 is dili. So therefore, your d sub 1 is equal to square root of 9, that is 3, square root of 10. And this is now your d1. Okay, kuha. Okay, kindly SS sa d1 na to. Kuha, question sa d1. So, ang process diri a class, same with sa ellipse. Okay, pariharagin sa ellipse class. Ang nagkalain lang niya karon sa step number 2. Okay. So, patanag dito ha, anhita sa dito. Okay, question lang class. No, tingog lang. Okay, basig ako'y basulo ninyo sa ano no. Basig mo, ingon mo. O, man, nag-discuss si sir. O, man, na-discuss ay. Okay, sige. Anhita, dito. So, dito is equal to the square root of x minus 1. Ay, x sub 1. X minus 1. Minus x sub 2 square plus y sub 1 minus y sub 2 square. Then, of course, ang atong gamiton si f sub 2 and negative 4, 0. O ang atong p given by negative 5, 0. Okay. So, inana karon ang atong given. Okay. D2, d sub 2 is equal to square root of x sub 1, mao nang negative 4, minus x sub 2 is negative 5 square plus naadayang kay y sub 1 is 0 then y sub 2 is this is 3 not, y sub 1 is 0 y sub 3 is y sub 2 is 3 square then simplify d2 or d sub 2 is equal to the square root of negative 4 minus negative 5 now according to the rules ingon niya kopyahon that's negative 4 negative times negative 5, that's positive 5 square. Plus 0 minus 3 square. 0 minus 3 is negative 3 square is equal to 9. Okay? Simplify. So we have d sub 2 is equal to square root of okay, negative 4 plus 5. No? Copy the sign of the bigger number, then proceed to subtraction. So negative 4 plus 5, that's 1. Squared is 1 plus 9. So, ang atong dito is equal to 1 plus 9, that's square root of 10. Now, sir, can we simplify square root of 10. So, wala na. Tungod kay square root of 10, wala tayong number na ipag-multiply. Ang isa ka factor is perfect square. So, pwede sa 5 times 2, pero 2 is not a perfect square. So, therefore, D is just equal to square root of 10. Okay. Next, step number 2, class. Ikaduha nga, gedumdumi. Ang atong D1 is 3 square root of 10. Atong D2 is square root of 10. Now, step number 2, get the absolute value of the difference between the two distances. Then, equate it to 2a. Ingon niya, puhaon daw kuno natong absolute value, difference of the absolute value. So, D1 minus D2 is equal to 2a. Ay, equate lang na nato to 2a. D1 or the D sub 1, the distance of the first distance, minus the second distance. Take the absolute value of that, then equate to 2a. Muna itong step number 2. So, step number 2, atong i-solve dito sa PICAS. Okay? To be follow. So, remember, pila ganit ang atong one class, pila ang atong first, ang atong D1. Absolute value of D1 minus D2 is equal to 2a. Pila atong D1?
3 square root of 10.
No, naminaw gid ay. Ang D2 square root of 10. Okay. So na kay values. Ang imo lang buhaton, di ba last time diri kay D1 plus D2 sa ellipse. This time pag-abot kang hyperbola minus D sub 1 minus D sub 2, no, absolute value of that is equal to 2a. Now given absolute value of D1, 3 square root of 10 minus square root of 10, which is equal to 2a. Okay. So, absolute value 3 square root of 10 minus square root of 10 is equal to 2a. Now, accordingly, no, diria, sir, unsaon man ana to pag-subtract? No, dumduman, balikan na po na ninyo ang rules of radicals. So, di na ito magbalik, ana. Inyo na lang ang inyo na lang ang i-preview na lang na ninyo dito nga part. No, I know nga gitudluan mo nagmaay ni Sir Bob sa inyong rules of radicals. No, sa inyo ng grade 9 subject. Okay. Next, C3. Unya diri ang sa left side, 3 square root of 10. Sa PICAS is only square root of 10. Now remember, square root of 10 na ana siya 1 nga tapad. That's constant. No, karon this is a subtraction of radicals. Tanawa ang atong radicand, di ba pareha square root of 10. Ang rules niya diha, pag parihag square root of 10 or pareha og radicand, kopyahon lang na nato. Ang ato lang i-operate ang number nga na sa iyang gawas. So sa PICAS, sa left side is 3, sa right side is only 1. 1 ha? Sir, asa mang 1 nga wa man makita diha? That's constant. Okay. So copy absolute value. Then, 3 minus 1, that's 2. Then, copy lang dahin ka sa imong radicand. That's square root of 10. But therefore, 3 square root of 10 minus square root of 10 is just 2 square root of 10, which is equal to 2a. Now, absolute value of this one is just equal to 2 square root of 10. It's equal to 2a. Now, accordingly, find the value of a. How are we going to find the value of a? Now, to find the value of A, of course, we need to divide both side by 2, divide by 2 for us to come up with A. 2A divided by 2 is A. 2 square root of 10 divided by 2. Now, 2 divided by 2 is 1. Ang nabilin is square root of 10. And this is now the value of our A. Nasundan? So, therefore, no, therefore, the distance from the center of hyperbola to one of its vertices is just square root of 10 units. This is now the final answer. Question? Class? Wala? Okay, balikan
sir,
na to.
Yes? Outside lang ang i-divide atong 2, sir. Dili yes. Nakasama ang ano square root of 10. Permanent siya sir no. Outside lang mag-divide.
Right, ma-divide lang nato ning apil ang 10 once na operation. Pag for example, That's 2 plus kana, no? Kay different man na sila. So kani pwede man nato ang denominator, pwede man nato bulagon. Then square root of 10 divided by 2. But this time, ang 2 is tapad, no? That's part of square root of 10, tapad man. So that is why, sir, nganong na-divide man. So therefore, pag inani, no, walay operation nga nag-separate sa duha, then we can divide 2 and 2.
Okay, so, sir. Thank you.
Okay. So, pangutana, everyone? Nasabtan? Padong napuntag silent sanctuary aniron. Okay. Thank you. Padayon ta. Okay. Next, kaya na may pangutana, kindly SS. This will serve as your second, ano, kaning, say tawag na to, set word. So the foci of hyperbola are at positive negative 3, 0. The distance from, find the distance from the center of the hyperbola to one of its vertices. If P is negative 5, 4, the point on the graph. So same process in any class, ang ipangita is ang center, no, distance from the center of the hyperbola to one of its vertices. Meaning to say, ang ipangita, A, gihapon. Okay, so if that's the case, kindly take a screenshot. Okay? Next, how do you represent the equation of hyperbola? No, how about if ang atong given kay dili na points? Dili na ano, ang ipangita is ang equation. Unsao naman nato karon kaha pagkuha. Okay. Now to find the equation of hyperbola, we need to use unsa man the standard form of the equation. So accordingly, no sa atong diba sa atong hyperbola natay in ani. So kung ang atong graph na adiri a class, ay gamayon ra nato class murag na eh. Diri atam. So kung atong graph in ani no na adiha a naitawag ni ana. Pag ang atong graph na apo diri a pasaka no patong graph in ana na apoy tawag ana class iwi ra kaya nakurog ang pintil pen pila ko kay expired na ning pintil pen ako napalit nganong hiwi hiwi wait sa okay ana na siya assume nga dili na siya expired okay kung ingan ani daw kuno class atong graph na diri a sa diri ang line naka butang no ang tawag nato ani or kaning graph is located horizontally di ba horizontal pag muin kag horizontal meaning graph lies on x axis now pag may kag vertical kain ani siya from the word vertical no naa siya sa y axis okay so this is vertical ani ang porma now if the standard form of the equation of hyperbola with center at 0, 0. Pag may center at 0, 0, meaning to say it is located at the origin. Ang atong transverse axis is on the x-axis or horizontal. Now, if it is the case, given taog x squared over a squared minus y squared over b squared, which is equal to 1. So, kani ang atong equation nga? Gamiton if and only if the axis or the transverse axis is located in the horizontal. So therefore, kani atong gamiton nga formula. Now, how about if the center is at the origin and the transverse axis is on y-axis? Pag may kag y-axis, no? Pag mag-mention nga transverse axis is on y-axis or vertical, no? Vertical axis. Therefore, the formula that we are going to use is y squared over a squared minus x squared over b squared which is equal to 1. Then, mauna ni atong formula. Now, again, as you can observe, ang denominator AB, ang atong numerator x and y, if horizontal. Pag vertical, may mong y and x. So, as you can observe, last meeting, last sa atong ellipse, ang mag-change is ang A og B. Magkalain-lain na sila. Now, depende sa opening sa atong graph. Now, this time, ang ato ang hyperbola, magkalain-lain sila og numerator. Maguna si x squared kaysa kang y squared if horizontal. Pag vertical, maguna si y squared kaysa kang x squared. And at the same time, ang sign nga itong gigamit is minus. Okay. How about, sir, if given day taog h and k? H and K are considered as the center of the given hyperbola. Now, if the center is at HK and the transverse axis is horizontal, no, horizontal daw, transverse axis meaning kania. Diri mo na, kung transverse axis is horizontal, so na daw kuno kay formula nga, x minus h squared over a squared minus y minus k squared over b squared. Mauna nga tong formula, if and the only if the center is given at h and k. Next, similarly, if the center is at hk and the transverse axis is vertical, then the equation of hyperbola will become, nara, may mong y minus k squared over a squared minus x minus h squared over b squared, which is equal to 1. And that is now the formula if and the only if given sa center and absent ang atong center, no? Or located at the h 0, 0 or located at the origin. So, mo na itong bantayanan. If horizontal, x ang naguna. If vertical, y ang naguna. And now, let us have example number 1. Okay. Example number 1, class. Anita karon, class? Kang example number 1. No. Example number 1, what is the standard form of the equation? No? What is the standard form of the equation of hyperbola with center at the origin, transverse axis on the x-axis, and a is equal to 5, b is equal to 3. Okay, kana ang atong pangitaon. Okay, so we have, wait sa class. So na kay transverse axis class is naadaw sa x-axis. Karon question, unsa atong gamiton nga formula? Transverse axis or naasa transverse axis on x-axis? Is it horizontal or vertical?
Horizontal.
Okay, horizontal. Now, since horizontal, then mugamit na aning formula. Then, ang yung standard daw kuno kay naman sa origin, therefore, x squared over a squared minus y squared over b squared, which is equal to 1. So, kana ang atong gamiton. Then, ato din identify ang value. A is equal to 5. B is equal to 3. Using the formula for this standard equation, x squared over a squared minus y squared over b squared, which is equal to positive 1. Now, wala man tayo h and k, kopya lang ka. We have x squared over a is 5 squared minus y squared over b squared, our b is 3 squared is equal to 1. Unsa na, ma'am? Next, we have x squared over 5 squared is 25 minus y squared over 3 squared is 9, which is equal to 1. And this is now the standard equation of hyperbola given the value of a and b. And using the transverse axis, no, na locate na to ang atong equation. No, transverse axis on the x-axis. Mo na dayon ni siya. No, mo na ang mga clue nga dapat natong dumduman. Okay, question. Pangutana.
Eh, sir.
Hello. Yes.
Sa focal distance man, sir, no, is dili na kailangan pangitaon sa basta origin.
Dili na basta mag-mention siya ang atong center is located at the origin, so no need to find the focal distance, no need to ano, kay iya ra mag-mention. Basta inani ang equation, class, inani ang dagan sa atong problem. Ang imo rang problemahon is, unsaon nimo pag-identify ang equation. Kung x over a or y over a ba siya? No? So to find the, ano, the equation, so to determine the kaning orientation of the equation, so you need to identify or you need to determine the word x-axis. No, transverse axis is on x-axis or vertical or horizontal or on sa diha. Now, if makuha na nimo, then makadetermine na ka unsang formula, unsang particular formula imong gamiton. Okay?
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Next. wala na tayo, wala yung laing pangutana, no? So therefore, the standard form of the equation of the given hyperbola is just x squared over 25 minus y squared over 9, which is equal to 1. Okay, next example. So find the standard form of the equation of hyperbola with center at their origin, then transverse axis on the y-axis is equal to a is equal to 8, and b is equal to 6. So a is 8, b is 6. All you have to do is determine the equation. Now, how are you going to determine the equation? Imura daw ko nunang tanawon. Transverse axis is, transverse axis is on the y-axis. Now, pag may kag y-axis, imong formula is, unsa man? That vertical. Is? Okay. Vertical. Okay, y-axis is vertical given y squared over a squared minus x squared over b squared, which is equal to 1. So, in ano imong formula? Kung saan mo na yung pag-identify using a, b, imo irang i-substitute. And that will be, that is your answer. Okay, kindly SS, kaning try it, no? This will be the third set work. Okay, kindly take a screenshot. So, next, we have, okay, how about if inani na og pormahan? Nanantay, inana nga mga pormahan class. Determine the standard form of the equation of a hyperbola whose center is at 2, negative 1, transverse axis is vertical, then B is equal to 8, then C is equal to 10. Now, naana kay center, naana kay B and C, pero wala kay A. Ang imo daw ko nung transverse axis kay vertical. Pag vertical, unsa man ang atong equation? Naana kay 2 and, si 2 and negative 1 mo na itong center. Center is si 2, negative 1. So, pag may nag-center, mo na itong H, mo na itong K. Okay. Then, naa daw ko nung kay B is equal to 8, C is equal to 10. Okay, unsaon man na nato class? Unsay formula nga atong gamiton? Unsa ka nga formula atong gamiton class? Hello.
Wait, sir.
Nay transverse nga word. Unsa man nga formula atong gamiton sa standard?
Y squared over a squared minus x squared over b squared, sir.
Naa naman tay h and k. Mahimo na nga.
Y minus k squared, sir. Kato?
Okay, that's y minus k squared over a squared minus x minus h squared over b squared, which is equal to 1. Now, we cannot find or solve the standard equation directly tungod kay b is 8, c is 10. Wala pa tay value ni a. Remember, sa atong given equation, standard equation, ang gipangita is si A o si B. No? Kinsa gipangita, siya ray ihatag. Ayun na paghatag og sobra kay, no? Wa nay mobalik sa ato. Okay, so to find the value of A, so of course, we need to use the standard equation of, no? Or the equation of parabola derived, equation of parabola, ang sadaw? Equation of the given hyperbola, no, in finding a using the Pythagorean. So na kay b squared is equal to c squared minus a squared. Okay, given ka og b which is equal to 8 squared is equal to 10 squared minus a squared. Okay, continue lang, simplify. That's 8 squared is 64 is equal to 10 squared is 100 minus a squared. Then, simplify. So, kani si a squared, addition, subtraction na lang dahil natin apply. From negative, this will become a squared, positive. Then, 100 minus from positive 64, mahimong negative 64 then. Simplify, a squared is equal to 100 minus 64. That is 36. Now, a, square root of a squared is a, square root of 36, that is positive, negative 6. Absolute value of that, since we're talking about distance, so this will become positive 6 units. Therefore, A is equal to 6. Again, sir, nga nung positive man nga na may negative roots of 36, ikuhaan na to og absolute value tungod kay naghisgot ta about distance. Kuha? Kuha, sir. No? Kung lang itubag kay para di madelay. Kay padayon ta. So, y minus k squared over a squared minus 8, x minus h squared over b squared is equal to 1. Mone ang atong equation tungod kay dimension sa atong problem, the transverse axis is vertical. Pag mo ikag vertical, naa sa y axis. No? Pag vertical, y. No? Kay v man, ay, varog nga line. Char lang. Okay, vertical, then pag mo ikag horizontal, no? From the, starting with the letter h, so naghapa nga linya class. No? Para di na mag-struggle sa kalisod, so kana atong dumduman ng mga, no? Muna akong dumduman kay, of course, di ba ako bright sa college. Until now, bright eh, kasir. Dili gihapon. Sa college, dumdumanan ako nga word. Bigay mag-struggle mo ko, ana. Especially sa kadaghan sa math, no? So, matinga na lang ako nag-math major ko niya. Daghan nag-math na subject. So, maglibog ka, nag-time nga maglisod, no? Depende na sa kinsa to yung mga maayo. Ako ay di man. So, muna mag-struggle. So, may horizontal, so, vertical. Kay muna dumduman. Ah, okay. Vertical, muna ang V, so nagbarog na linya. Then h, naghapa ang linya. So, ana lang na siya nga. So, therefore, ato lang substitution. Si center, naadiha si h o si k. Si b, na si c, o naapod si a, which is equal to 6 now. So, all you have to do is apply substitution. So, we have y minus k, which is equal to negative 1. Negative 1 squared over a, which is equal to 6 squared. Minus x minus h, h is 2 squared over b. B is 8 squared, which is equal to 1. Then simplify y, na negative times negative 1, that's positive 1 squared over 6 squared is 36 minus x minus 2 squared over a to the power of 2, that is 64 equal to 1. And this is now the standard equation of a given hyperbola. Okay. So, muna karon ng atong given nga equation. Okay? Nasundan? So, dito na lang ito mag-stop sa equation. So, actually, class, no? Ang atong hyperbola o ellipse, hapit-lapit lang. Ang nagkabalyo lang niya, nagka-change lang niya is kaning sign between y and x, no, negative last time pag ellipse, positive plus, then pag abot sa kang hyperbola na minus siya. And at the same time sa hyperbola, no, ang mag-interchange ang numerator, pag ellipse ang denominator si a o si b, mo na magka interchange. Okay, sige. And the correct answer is y plus 1 squared over 36 minus x minus 2 squared over 64, which is equal to positive 1. Again, class, kaning numerator, di nato hilabtan. No? Kaya di man ta hilabto nun, char lang. Di nato hilabtan, class, accordingly, tungod kay, no, di man nato expand. Atong ipangita is the standard form of the equation. So, standard form. Only atong i-express is ang denominator. That is why from 6 squared, na himong 36, then 8 squared is 64. And that is now the final answer. Okay? So, 404 na. Next! So, what man tayo pangutana? Determine the standard form of the equation of hyperbola whose center is at negative 4, 3. Then, transverse axis is horizontal. Given A and given C. Ang A is 9, C is 16, pero wa tayo B. Okay, in ana atong kindly SS, take a screenshot, then add this one to your set work. Okay, sige. Next! Ani A. Now, diri A na ta mo eh. Tanggong na ta nino. Kinalasan. Nga part. Ano ka? I-exit sa sir. Ay, ma... I-off. Ay, delete ka ng red. I-red sa... Or i... Okay. Next! Okay, sige, padayon ta. Okay, sige. Determine the standard form of the equation of hyperbola with vertices 3, 1. No, atong i-take note ang atong pangitaan is ang standard form given ang iyang vertices. So nadaw ko na ay vertices nga B1 or vertex 1 is 3, 1. Ang vertex 2 nimo kay given kay 11, 1. Then ang imong focus F1 is negative 3, 1. O ang imong F2 kay naadayin kay 17 and positive 1. So pag ingaani class, unsaon man nato? No, same sa ellipse. Unsaon nato class? Yun sa nato tong ellipse last time. Giyon sa nato class? Secret, di ko magsaba. O, no, ganyan lang.
Ganun, sir.
Hmm? Unsa, Reynald?
Gamitan ko nag-distance formula, sir.
Okay, gamitag distance formula. Ano ko, gamitag na naong, sir. Okay, of course, gamitan na ito distance formula. But before we can use distance formula, we need to find the center. Sin. Okay. Okay. Gamitag naong, sir. No? Sige, padayon ta class. So given, so una daw natong buhaton ingon ni Reynald, no? Ano si Reynald kay nagtuon ni gikan or tumutuon pa. Okay. So to determine the standard form of the equation of the hyperbola, we need to identify first the orientation of its transverse axis. So sir, unsaon na to pag-identify nga wa man ni gi-mention? Okay, of course, we need to determine the values of A, B and the coordinates of the center. So to identify, no, to determine the orientation of the transverse axis of hyperbola and the corresponding standard form that should be used, of course, we need to connect the vertices, which are, no, i-connect sa natong vertices. So kung asa makabutang ang vertices, na-added to ang atong, unsuman, na-added to atong transverse axis. So una, tong vertices natay positive 3, negative, positive 3, positive 1. Positive 3 si X, 1, 2, 3. Then 1 da yun. So that is, next, 11 and 1. So that's 1 at 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Yeah, 1. So karon class, naadiri ang atong vertex. Pag naadiri atong vertex, is it horizontal or vertical?
Horizontal.
Okay, that's horizontal. Okay, so karon naka-identify na nato. Ah, okay. Mauday na siya, sir, no? Ang itong ipangita, horizontal. So karon horizontal atong transverse axis. So, i-note lang na, transverse axis. TA na lang na. Nagbuot-buot lagi kag initial, sir. Okay, that's horizontal. So, di magbuot kay ako yung nag-solve. Okay, horizontal. Pero kung atong isulat na, no, that's transverse axis na class. So horizontal atong transverse axis. So given vertex and the focus. So karon para ma-solve nato class, we need to, no, determine the center first. Pag mohingon kag horizontal kay atong equation, sir, kay okay, ingon niya pag horizontal, it's x minus h squared over a squared minus y minus k squared over b squared, which is equal to 1. Okay. Now, karon minus na ha. Muna na itong formula. Before ito makasolve daw kuno ani class, ang atong buhaton, pangitaon sa nato, una ang atong center. Okay. So, sa center, karon class, unsaon man ito pagpangita kang center, sir, unsay formula in finding midpoint? Or what is the midpoint formula? Given? Sa midpoint formula, galay class? That is, hello, everyone. What's the midpoint formula? Center.
X sub 1 plus X sub 2 over.
X sub 1 plus X sub 2 over
2.
2.
And Y 1 plus Y sub 2.
Plus Y sub 2 over 2. And that is now the formula in finding the center. Of course, asa man ta? Ani magkuha? Asa to magkuha sa x sub 1 o y sub 1? diri ata mag-focus kang center. Remember, ang giingon dito class, the midpoint of the vertex is our center. No, na given tag vertex 1 og vertex 2, V1 and V2. No, si V1 o si V2. Okay. The midpoint of that is our center. So all you have to do is to determine x and y. X sub 1, pag may kag x, that is the first element of a given ordered pair. Pag may kag first element, pinakauna nga number given sa imong ordered pair, no? Kung sa ato nang inis pinulungan, no, mo na iingon niya. So second, to identify y, mo na ang ikaduhang element sa atong ordered pair. So nakay V1, V2, first 3 and 11, nakay 1 and 1. So of course, ato lang dayon na siyang beto permahan. Ay kabala ka sir, wait sa sir. Na pressure ko ni RC Munoz. Kani si Munoz no kay paas if man ipaperma perma dire, pwede ra na mulaos na. Huwag, gikan to nang ihi. ORC ha? Okay, padayon. Wilain lagi tong kamot ni ORC ha. Okay, padayon ta class. Okay, sige. So x nakay 3 plus x sub 2 is 11 over 2. Nakay y 1 plus y sub 2 is 1 over 2. Then simplify, that is 3 plus 11, that's 14 over 2. Then 1 plus 1 is 2 over 2. Then simplify. So we have 14 divided to 7. 2 divided 2 is 1. And this is now our center. Center is, again, dumduma na to, pila tong center. Okay? Kung siya imong center sa imong kinabuhi, dumdumi siya, char lang. Okay. Next na tong buhaton. On sa mandayon, sir? Okay, buhaton na to, anak class. Para ma-solve na nato ang atong standard equation, of course, we need to find the value of A, the value of B, and also the value of C. Okay, with the given information, we first determine values of A and C. We can do this in two ways. Either we get the distance between the vertices and foci and divide and then divide each distance by 2 to get the values of A and C respectively, or we get the distance from the center to a vertex and a focus. So pwede karon nato atong gamiton is distance formula. Okay? So pwede ra nga distance formula atong gamiton class. Again, center. So, para makuha nato ang atong A, di ba pag muingon kag A class daw. Pag may kag A, that is the distance from center to vertex. Therefore, ang ato ding gamiton class kay vertex ug si center. Pila ang atong center? 7. Okay. So, para makuha nato ang ano, we need to use distance formula. Again, pag may kag distance formulas, as what we had done a while ago, nga ingon niya, x sub 1 minus x sub 2 squared plus y sub 1 minus y sub 2 squared. And that is now a formula. Now, para makuha na to, ingon niya, mupili lang ka. It's either v sub 1 or v sub 2. Mupili ka ng duha class. Asa may atong isolve? Sige na lang, si V na lang. V sub 1, pila to, that's 3, positive 1. Pila ang center? Center na to kay 7, positive 1. Okay. Asa gikan diri ah? Si V sub 1, gikan diri sa vertex. Okay, we are trying to find the value of A. Again, A is the distance or length from center to vertex. Mauna siya class, no? Nasundan? Oh, sir. Ako ito bag. Oh, sir. Padayon. Okay, sige. Okay, sige class. Anita? Si x sub 1, dili na din ka mag-base. Again, dili lang kay 3 and 1. Pwede ka kang 11 og 1, ha? Nag-focus lang ko kang 3 and 1. Mao may v sub 1. So, kung kinsa to'y nauna, siya una, ha? Ayaw tong nagsunod. No? Dita mamili o kinsa na yung naguna. Derita. Okay, so we have X sub 1 din ikaw mag-base kang V sub 1 og or vertex 1 og kang center. So we have 3 minus 7 squared plus Y sub 1 is 1 minus 1 squared. Okay, so we have now na-anada yung kay pila na siya. 3 minus 7, that's negative 4 square. Then 1 minus 1 is 0 squared, that's 0. So that is now, so we have negative 4 squared, that's 16. So A is equal to square root of 16 is just positive negative 4. Absolute value positive negative 4, that is 4. So therefore, A is just equal to 4. Kumuha na karon. Again, dumduman na to si center, 7, 1. Si A is 4. Now, balik ta. Pangitaon na to si C. No? Again, C ag A ang atong pangitaon tungod kay given man ang atong focus. Remember, given ang focus o ang vertex. No? Karon para makuha ang atong A, sa vertex ta magtanaw. Pag makuha atong C, magtanaw ta kang focus. Kaya nga naman, gikan ni center to focus 1, ang distance or ang length niya is C. So therefore, mo na siya. So anhindayon ta kang pagpangita sa atong C. So sa pagpangita sa atong C class, given tag focus nga, pila gato focus da, sir? Na kay F1 nga negative 3, positive 1. And F2 kay na kay 17 and positive 1. Okay. So we have also our center. Center nato class, remember, ang atong center kay 7, positive 1. No? Asa na gikan 7, positive 1, center nato. Okay, magpili na po dayong kani, it's either F1 or si F2 o ang atong center. So given, since C atong ipangita, so C atong ilet. Let C is equal to the square root of X sub 1 minus X sub 2 square plus Y sub 1 minus Y sub 2 square. Then, asa man atong tanawon ani class? F1 or F2? Okay, ako na po magtubag. F1 ra sir. So atong tanawon na po na. Again, class, kung F2 imong gamiton, ang answer ana, same with ang answer sa F1. Same ra na sila. Again, pariha. So ayaw kabala ka, class, kung diri ko nag-focus kang F1, kaya mo mo ginag-una. Okay. Siya may nag-una, siya ay ako i-prioritize. Na di, tama mili. Okay, we have C is equal to the square root of, pero it's up to you na ha, kung unsay inyong gamiton, basta kaya ako, matoy akong gibuhat. Okay, so we have X sub 1, so X is the first element of the given ordered pair, CY is the second element of the given ordered pair. Now, X, we have negative 3 minus X sub 2 is 7 squared plus Y sub 1 is 1 minus 1 squared. Then, simplify, C is equal to the square root of, we have negative minus 7, no, parihag sign, kopyaha, so negative, then proceed to addition, that's positive, negative 10 squared plus 1 minus 1 is 0. So 0 man na siya, of course, kanina lang da yun. No, kung wana na siya ay, wana ay pulos, no, kuha na ay value para ni mo, ay nanasig apila. So we have C is equal to square root of negative 10 squared, that is 100. Nung anong 100? Kay si negative 10 nakasulod sa parenthesis raised to the power of 2. So that is why square root of 100. Now accordingly, square root of 100, that is equal to positive negative 10. Now we are talking about distance, so therefore, itong gigamit is the positive roots of 100. Okay. Kaya nga naman sir, the absolute value of positive negative 10 is just positive 10. Okay. Ang A is 4, C is 10. Now, pila ang B. Okay. Naana kay A, naana kay C, wapatay B. No. Ang atong A, remember A is 4, ang C is 10. What is B? Now, makuha na to si B class, pinaagi kang B squared is equal to C squared minus A squared. Okay. So, B squared is equal to C is 10 squared minus A squared, no, that's 4. Then simplify, B squared is equal to 10 squared, that's 100, minus 4 squared is 16. Now, what is 100 minus 16? So, B squared is equal to, pila na siya class, that is 100 minus 16. Okay, that's 84, sir. Thank you. Okay, very good. Okay, next. So, since 100 minus 16 is 84, then find the value of B. Square root of B squared, that's B. Square root of 84 is pila class. Okay, wala, sir. Okay, karon wala. Okay, thank you. So, kay wala man karoy square root of 84, wala man ta, di man say perfect square. So, to simplify square root of 64, pwede ta mag-apply sa rules of radicals. Okay, again, rules of radicals, kamunay bahala na og review kung unsa tong mga rules addition, rules subtraction, rules sa pag-inani, no, pag-simplify. Okay, so, karon kaning rules ani diri a, ang ingon niya, para ma-simplify daw na tong 84, square root of 84, mangita ta og factor of 84 nga perfect square. Okay, number nga pag i-multiply nato mahimo og 84. Ang isa sa number is perfect square, ang isa kay prime number. Pwede in ana, no? Pwede siya. So we have B is equal to square root of, that is 4 times. Unsa nga number? That is 4 times 21, sir. Okay, thank you. That's 21. 4 times 21, that is 84. Okay? Now, this time, 4 is a perfect square. Then, 21 is, ano man siya? Pwede na to na siya, no? Di na siya factorable. So, ay, naday say 7 o 3. Pero, dili perfect square. Okay, see, only 4. So, therefore, B is just equal to, square root of 4 is 2, square root of 21. And this is now value of our B. Remember, A is 4, C is 10, B is 2, square root of 21. Okay. Since kinaan naman tayo value, take a screenshot sa no, para dito mag-struggle sa kalisod. So, take a screenshot. Kumana? Okay. Yes, karon, naana kay value. So, naana kay value kung gi-value kaniya, no? Kung gitagaan kaniya value sa iyang char. Okay, A is 4. B is equal to 2 square root of 21. C is equal to 10. Now, ang atong center, pila gani atong center? Pila atong center?
7-1.
Okay. So, 7, this is our H. This is our K. Then, substitution lang ka. So, we have X. So, X minus H, 7 squared over A is 4 squared minus Y minus K. K is 1 squared over B is 2 square root of 21. Square, which is equal to 1. Sige daw. Sige daw. Ato i-simplify. That's X minus 7 squared. Then 4 squared is 16. Minus Y minus 1 squared over kani, what is at 2 square root of 21 squared. Pila na? Ambot, sir. Ikaw may nag-answer. Okay. Ako na po'y padayon. So, kan is ito? Kana, di ba si ito i-distribute? So, 2, nahimong 2 squared, mahimong ng 4. So, 2 to the power of 2 is 4 times C square root of 21. Unsa man na siya, class? Pila'y bilin? Okay. Very good. Okay. Thank you. Square root of 21. Kan is si di ba index ano is 2? Unya na kay exponent nga 2. Matanggal, ma-eliminate na. Ang nabilin, nasa sulod is 21. Thank you. Very good. Now, karon inana naman sa format, no? Makatawar ako sa kagaligod eh. Very sad reality. Okay, sige pa dayon. Ang exponent class, di na nato si simplify. Okay. Copy lang x minus 7 over x minus 7 squared over 16 minus y minus 1 squared over 4 times 21 is? Okay, that's 84 is equal to 1. And this is now the standard equation of the hyperbola. Kuha, nasundan. Sunod, no? Mga napulo ra kaingon ani unya di ko maghatag og multiple choice. Murag sakto-sakto naman sa inyo, no? Makalipong na gamay.
Taas og equation or solution, sir.
Unya pangitaon pagid nako ang step by step nga solution. No? I-check nako kada step by step 1 point. Makulangan minus 1, minus 1. Nilahos ta gikan sa equation, nilahos sa solution, our final answer, awa na. Si Orok ang score nga out of one item 20 points. Nidiretso sa answer, 1 point lang imo. Out of 20, no? Hinana ako, labi nag face to face. Last time ba itong batch nila, ano? Ilakin sa itong batch, eh. Sir, sakto man ako. Asa yung solution? Okay, wala. Teorok. Ano na? Okay, sige. Question? SS class, atong final answer. So, atong gibuhat ani formiro, no? Mato siya atong formiro, gibuhat. Nangita taog. Unsa man? Nangita atong gideterminate ang transverse axis hyperbola, if it is horizontal or vertical, then right after ana na determine nato, ato na dayong ikuha ang midpoint formula using x sub 1 plus x sub 2 over 2, then y sub 1 plus y sub 2 over 2. Then nakuha nato center, ato na dayong gi-determine ang, okay, of course, gikuha nato ang distance formula. Now sa distance formula gikuha si a og c. Since sir nganong a og c mangyud di man ta mag b. Remember, ang A is ang notation that represents the distance from center to one of its vertex. Now, si C is represents siya from center to focus. That is why A and C ang atong gi siguro, no? Si B karon plus makuha na nato through Pythagorean theorem, which is given by B squared is equal to C squared minus A squared, no? Kana siya. Then after ana class, na naman tayo value, of course, diretso na din ta sa substitution method. Substitution process using values of A, B, and its center. Using the formula, the standard form of the equation of hyperbola. Nakuha class na sabdan? Or, sir, wala ako ng sabdan pero naay gamay. So, okay na po na. Pasabot na. Nga, we are still processing our so, of course, no? Di man ta mga maayo. Na, mo admit makuha na. Nga, di man po kumaayo. Usahay maglurat o mga mata usahay sa exam, no? Para sa exam atong Sabado, natuog ko ginagmay, answer po nga ginagmay. O, oh, di ba classic? Exam ko sa, ano, masters na ako sa Sabado. Mato siya, gibati mako katugon, niya di man makaya gud nga, imuklat gud ang mata, natuog sa ako. Power nap! Pag-iog mata na ako, hala, humana silang tanan. Oh, moto, wala na ko yung nahimo, nibarog na lang po kong nag-submit. Ana ng show, no? Kung di makaya, di pugson. Okay, pangutana? Class? 4:30 naman din class. No, grabe pangawat na kuguras. Karoon na kay exam naman din sunod adlaw. Pakukain po itong exams class. Okay, pangutana? Way pangutana? Way mutingog?
Wala na, sir.
Kinupin ka na, sir. Oh, okay. Sige. Paano, sir? Kukuman na, sir. Okay, so far. So na actually class na pa nay sumpay. No? Naulaw lang ko kay na kuan mag naulaw na lang ko sa inyo eh, kindi naman ko ninyo tingugan. So sige na lang. Ang sumpay ani class pwede i-record na lang nako, na akong ipadala sa Telegram, charla. I-record din ako na lang nang ipaano sa inyo, no? Kung makaangay mo. Okay, sige. So, para mas ma-practice wag ninyo inyong learning sa atong i-klase. Karon kindly take a screenshot, okay? And add this one to your test work. Okay, humana? Okay. Ang ato na ding ano, ang akong i-send sa inyo is about general form to standard. Standard, so, bubo naman lang po nga part. Okay, ay kabalaka. Okay, so far, so later maghatag ko again ang atong covered sa exam class is from sa tawag na to ani? Ellipse. No, ellipse. Definition, properties, equation of ellipse. Then sunod, hyperbola, definition and equation, properties of hyperbola. And that is our coverage for our examination.
Okay. From exactly like that, actually.
Sir,
right.
Pwede pa check out ang last week, sir. Patanong ako, wala na ako na screenshot, sir.
One.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Oh my God, it is so laggy.
Wala tayong mga pagdumot. Okay, so tana, namoy na-learn nga, no, basin makaingon bong basig at the end of the day, basig mahuman atong mahumanay na bitong semester, matingon nga pamang ko'y learning sa subject ni Sir Rocky, uy, murang tugoy puso. No? Basig maingon na no? So, I hope na may na-learn sa atong discussion. Basig maingon mo nga, lahira man among junior high nga, kung ano, uy, murang itudluan man migtarong dito niya, dito nagbinuang roman. No, Jorrel, no? Girecord pag ito nga itong mga... Okay, nag-stop na kag-recording, Jorrel. Ay, wala pa di ay. Basing mo sikat na di ba? Okay, sige. Maura to Jorrel, no? Kaya basing ma-report as principal. So, time check. It's 4:31 in the afternoon. Thank you, everyone. Thank you for listening. Thank you for joining us this afternoon. And God bless. See you next day.
Thank you, sir.
Bye!
Bye, sir. Thank you, sir.